second leadership summit of I Am Raipur on leadership and socio-economic prosperity. I am Amandeep Nanda from the Media and Public Relations Committee. We are privileged to have with us Mr. Abhay Kapoor, who is the head HR of North India region, Amazon. Thank you for your precious time, sir.
Thanks.
So how does an organization align its business strategy with its people strategy?
So business and people are for each other, and most of the business strategies, like, it's more of an alignment of individual aspiration with the business goals. This is what HR primarily drive, and how to align the business goals with the people aspiration. Because if people aspirations are not aligned to business goals, people will not feel motivated and they will not feel engaged with the organization. And so it's about communicating very well in terms of cascading down the top business goals of it starts from the board level. So what are the board level business goals, then what is the functional level business goals, CEO level business goals, and then after that the department level, and then it goes down up to the manager level and the team members level. So how you communicate with them, how you design it, and how you involve all the team members in designing those goals, that helps in succeeding business and aligning people aspirations with the business goals. So that is the most successful model which I've seen getting implemented in a couple of organizations, and that's the key thing which delivers and helps organization in making the fast growth and keeping their people motivated.
Okay, sir. Sir, I read an article online where it was mentioned that people with the right attitude should be preferred with people over the right skills. But in startups, with generally the number of employees are pretty low. Is it useful there also?
Yeah, so when we talk about learning, we talk about knowledge, skills and attitude. And all three goes hand in hand with each other. But attitude is always preferred, because skills nowadays can be given to the employees, and knowledge can be acquired even at any point of life through different media, different channels. But attitude is something which need to be built over a period of time, and which is very difficult to change. So that is why while recruiting people, we use a lot of psychometric tests, a lot of behavior based interviews to identify that whether the person is the right fitment in the organization, whether he is gelling with the culture, whether he has that kind of aspiration to grow in the business, grow in the role, what is his level of interest, what is his attitude towards business and organization and towards people. So you are right that attitude plays a major role as compared to knowledge and skills.
So in today's world, where there is a lot of competition, a lot of people feel stressed out and saturated after a couple of years working. So how can an HR help them?
So the HR, as a part of its HR philosophy, we always try to provide opportunities in terms of job enrichment or job enlargement, moving them from one role to another role, vertically and horizontally, to different functions, or making them responsible for a larger role in the same function. So it's all about making them grow with the business. So as long as people are growing and contributing towards business, looking for a larger pie of their contribution in the organization, they remain motivated. But there are, we have come across few individuals, those who don't want to, those who don't have very high ambition, and they don't want to stretch much, rather they are more happy than whatever they got in their life. So there are some roles which in a lot of organizations, we have a couple of roles in support functions where those roles are more of a routine and stagnant kind of roles. So these kind of people, those who doesn't have much desire to stretch, they fit in well there. You don't need 100% people who are outperformers or whatever. So an organization needs a balance of people. So there should be certain percentage as very, very high performing people, and certain percentage as stagnant people. So those who continue those who are more supporting organization in terms of their longer tenure in the organization with a similar role, and they carry that knowledge. So any clarification on that? If you further want to probe on this.
So one last question, how was your overall experience at the leadership summit at IIM Raipur?
So I believe it is well organized, and I was quite impressed with the topics which you have chosen, which is very relevant with the today's challenges which we are facing. Entrepreneurship is something which is growing at a very rapid pace in India. A lot of people are getting into startups, and they really need this kind of debate and understand different challenges which we are facing in terms of success rate of startups in India.
Okay. So thank you for valuable insights. It was nice. Thank you.